So in question 6, the first one is from banking topic, from banking chapter question. Rita Divan has recurring deposit account in a bank for 3 years. Okay, this is the time at 11% per annum. So rate of interest is 11. And if its maturity value is 16,842, maturity value is given and find monthly installment paid by her. Monthly installment means P value we need to find out, the principal for every month. So let's take the given data and solve this problem. So in this, let monthly installment be x. Okay, otherwise the monthly installment is p. Let me take any data. Let monthly installment so take rupees p. Okay, and time is 3 years. Given time is 3 years. If you convert into the months, that is 36 months. Then n is equal to 36. Okay, and rate of interest is 11%. So r value is equals to 11%. These 3 are given. And we need to find out the interest first. So if you observe the question, maturity value is 16,842. So maturity amount is given. Then we'll apply the interest paid. So how much interest you're supposed to pay, that will take first. Okay, then we know the formula, simple interest is equals to, so P into N into N plus 1 by 2 into 1 by 12 into R by 100. So this is the simple interest formula. Right, so in this formula, if you take, so this is the simple interest formula, you should apply. Simple interest is not given, but we'll take the simple interest is equals to P is, we are taking x into 36 months, 36 into 37 by 2 into 1 by 12, rate of interest is 11, so 11 by 100. And simple interest, now this is if you simplify first, if you simplify this total, 36, you can cancel here, 12 ones are, 12 threes are, 36, and 3 into 37 into 11 by 2 into 100, this is complete. Okay, then 3 into 37 into 11 by 2 into 100 is 200x. Total value into x is separate. Now this is the interest paid. Now according to the question, the maturity value is given. So according to the problem, the maturity value is equals to p into n plus simple interest. So principal for every month into number of months into simple interest. So according to this, maturity value is mentioned. The question 16,842. 16,842 is given. Now P is X, N is 36. So 36X plus, and this is the 3 into 37 into 11 by 200 into X. Right. Just you'll simplify this. That is 16,842 12X. Just you can simplify this total. Take the values on side. If we take x common, 36 means 36 by 1 plus 3 into 37 into 11 by 200, 16,842. Now using this we can get the value of x. So I'm taking these values now. Let us calculate these ones. To make the calculation simple, instead of taking a lot of multiplications, just try to take 3 common, it will become more simple. That is 12. Okay, 12 is 36. 12 by 1 plus, here is 3 common, right? So 37 into 11 by 200. That is 16,842. Now 3 you can cancel, this is 3 table. So here are 3 ones are 3, and this if we cancel, this is of 3 5s are 15. 6 1 4. Okay, make it simple to easy for cancellations. Then 5 6 1 4 is equals to, then 12 by 1 plus this into this, then that is the 12x. X is there, so 12x plus, and 37 into 11 into x, so 407x by 200. Then do LCM, 12x means 12 by 1, then we'll get 2807x by 200. Okay, 12 into 200 and plus this 12 200, so okay, 2400 plus this 2807, that is equals to 5614. Try to make easy calculations, so simple. Then x is equals to 5614 into 200 by 2807. Okay, if you observe, this is exactly cancel one time. Observe this is 1s and 2s. Mostly you give calculations easily. That is equals to 400. Simple. So monthly installment paid by is 400. So rupees 400 is the monthly installment, right? And see the next one. This is an adjoint figure. ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to CD and AB is 2 times the DC. So AB is the double to this DC. Determine the ratio of the areas. Triangle AOB and triangle COD. First you prove AOB and COD are similar. Then you can use the ratios formula, area of the ratios. Let us take this. Okay, given two lengths are parallel, other two are non-parallel. This is the one is double, and join this, they intersect at O. Okay, and this is the AB, base is AB, is exactly parallel to CD, then intersecting at O. Now AOB triangle and DOC triangle, we have to prove similar first. So according to the given, if you write the given data, that is AB is parallel to CD and AB is equals to twice the DC, 2 times DC, that means AB by DC is equals to 2 by 1. Okay, let B. Now we'll prove these two triangles are similar. Then from triangle AOB and triangle COD, okay, from this both, these two are vertically opposite angles, okay, angle AOB and angle DOC, and because of these two lines are parallel, these two are alternate angles, alternate interior angles, and other two also alternate interior angles. Two angles, if two is enough, the two rules you take. So angle AOB is equals to angle COD. These both are equal because of vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles are equal. And next is angle OAB is equals to angle OCD. Okay. These two are equal, just to explain, alternate interior angles. Another side also you can take, anything you can take, one set, because double A property is enough, double A axiom. This is OCD and this alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles are equal. Then therefore triangle AOB is similar to triangle COD. So this is by AA axiom. Two angles are same, then automatically third angle also is equal. Now if you observe, if any two triangles are similar, then area of the two triangles are equal to squares of the corresponding sides, you know that property. Then that if you write, therefore whenever two triangles are in similar, therefore area of triangle AOB by again area of triangle COD, that is equal to squares of the corresponding sides. So I am taking AB squared by CD square, because we know AB by CD is 2 by 1. So this is 2 square by 1 square. So 4 by 1. Then areas are in 4:1 ratio. So therefore, area of triangle AOB is to area of a triangle COD are in 4:1 ratio. Okay. This is the only property you should take and apply. And let us see the next question. This is from applications of trigonometry. So if you observe the question, an aeroplane is flying horizontally with a speed of 173.2 meter per second. Speed is given here. In the height of 3000 meters, find the time it would take for angles of elevation of the plane as seen from the point on the ground to change from 60 to 30 degrees. By changing 60 to 30 degrees, how much time it takes? That only we should find out. So let me draw the diagram and explain you to understand clearly. So height is 3000 meters in two cases. So let me take this. First we draw the diagram. So height is 3000 meters and two ways it changed. The person is observing from the base. One is 30 degree, one is 60 degrees. So which is far is 30 degrees, 30 degrees to 60 degrees it change. And join these sides, same height. Okay, now if you observe this, okay, one is AB and it is C and D and E. Height is 3000 meters. So then this also same 3000 meters. Then an angle is 30 degrees. This 30 degrees and this is the 60 degrees, which is near. Okay. So if observe 60 degrees to 30 degrees, it changes. 60 to 30. So from A to D it is past this. So within the time is mentioned from here to there. That is 173.2 meters per second. So if you find out the distance between them, then you can apply this concept, because speed is equal to distance by time. So distance, if you can find it from A to D, speed is no, you know the speed. AD is nothing but equals to BE. Okay, even if you can find out the value of BE, let BE is X. If we can find out the BE, then we can solve this problem easily. So here is our two rectangle triangles. First one, triangle ABC. So let the plane take x seconds to change the deviation from 60 to 30. That we can take x, or we can take x, t seconds. Let the plane take t seconds to change from 60 degrees to 30 degrees. Height is same, height is not changed. Then in triangle ABC. So from triangle ABC, then tan 60. Tan theta is opposite by adjacent. So tan 60 is AB by BC. Okay, AB by BC. Then tan 60 is root 3. Root 3 is equals to AB by BC. So from this, BC is equals to, and AB is a 3000. Then root 3 is equal to AB distance is same, 3000 by BC. Then from this BC is equals to 3000 by root 3. Okay. Let it be equation 1. So we got the BC value. And next from triangle DCE, we'll find the total of this from DCE triangle. CDE. Now in triangle, we take triangle CDE, from this tan 30, because 30 degrees opposite by adjacent, opposite is the DE and adjacent is C base. Same here also, the D is 3000 meters DE. Then tan 30 value is 1 by root 3, This is a 3000 by CE. Then from this, CE is equals to 3000 into root 3, okay, by doing cross multiplication. So CE value is 3000 into root 3. Now from this both, BC and CE we got, B to C and total C to E. Then X is equals to, from this C to E minus CB, then you will get X value, okay, CE minus CB. Then second minus first, then that is X. Then X is equals to CE minus CB, that is the 3000 root 3 minus 3000 by root 3. By taking 3000 common in this to make the calculation simple, root 3 minus 1 by root 3. Do LCM. 3000 root 3 root 3 is 3, so 3 minus 1 by root 3. Then that is 3 minus 1 is 2. Just calculate simple, and 3000 into 2 by root 3 value. So this is up to here, and we can take by cancellation if you want. Okay, let it be here this X value, then that is equal to speed. Now let it take this speed value now. Okay, from this, if you want to do more clear, instead of taking denominator is root 3, if you want as numerator, this I am writing 3 into 1000, okay, and 2 by root 3. Next up, this 3 I can write root 3 into root 3, and into 1000 into 2 is 2000 by root 3. So 1 root 3 get cancelled, then that is equals to 2000 root 3 meters, okay. Now this is the value of X, that means that is the distance. So distance from this both places, so from A to B. So this value is distance, that is X. We got the distance now. Now we just apply the speed formula. Okay. To get the distance only, we should solve first. Now once you know, just I'm writing here. Now the speed is equals to, generally we know speed formula is distance by time. Now distance is equal to 2000 root 3 by time I had taken t seconds, but the problem speed is given, that is 173.2 meters per second. Okay. Then that is equals to 173.2. Then from this both, 2000 root 3 by t is equals to 173.2. Then just to cancellation this. T is equals to 2000 root 3 by 173.2, and we know the value of root 3. So 2000 into root 3 value is 1.732 by 173.2. Just to do cancellations this, same denominator, no, you can cancel it simple. That is, if you observe, this is 1.732 ones are, and this is 100, sir, because point is here. So this 100 ones are 120, sir. That's it. That is 20 seconds. So aeroplane would take 20 seconds to change the angle of elevation from 60 degrees to 30 degrees as the sea or point is seen from the sea. Okay, you can solve in this way. So whenever the speed is given, first you'll find out the distance, then you can apply for that. Okay, right, you can solve this. And now let's take question number C and we'll solve these problems.